Me presento aquí a Zasiewicz. Un fuerte aplauso para ella, por favor.
To see see how they kind of go in that direction. You know, I'm not in the script writing process there, so I don't know, but that's something I think would be really interesting, like, space to explore for Domino.
Also, especially with women empowerment, we see also working at movies. We saw with Wonder Woman, we see with Captain Marvel, and we see the female presence more headlined in these big movies.
Yeah.
How do you feel about those actions having that?
Yeah. I mean, I think it's amazing. I mean, I just think about, most of you have seen Endgame, I'm assuming, right? I mean, I'm not going to give away anything for those. But like, I remember there's this one scene toward the end where like all the women come together to fight Thanos. And I had like kind of an emotional reaction to it. I was sort of surprised, you know, I don't think you really realize how much those things really matter until you see it. And you're like, oh, I was missing that. And I love seeing how strong, like, I mean, Captain Marvel is like a, or even like Scarlet Witch, it's like it's a very kind of visceral thing to feel that strength, and I hope that like Domino can become like a larger part of that conversation, and you know I really would love to have sort of a Domino film, and that's probably going to be, I'm going to have to probably like lead the train on that, but I think it is really important. Because there are women that are physically strong and, you know, can do this, so.
Yeah, the part, remember I have an 11-year-old daughter.
Oh, yeah.
And when she saw that part, she loved it. She was
really?
Like, yeah, because she could relate it to some of the movie.
Yeah.
So she's Tony Stark, there's Captain America, and she couldn't relate it that personally, but once the female went on to fight scene, she
do.
Got hooked into it.
You really do relate differently, and of course you relate to the other characters and to the male characters and their situations, like, of course you do, but there is something for anybody, whether that's sort of like in terms of age, of seeing somebody your age on screen, or in terms of your gender or your sexuality or the color of your skin or whatever it is, it really does profoundly make a difference to be like, oh, I'm acknowledged in this way as well. And so I loved that.
Yeah. And since we're going to your next project is The Joker.
Mm-hmm.
Can't get a better Joker. We want to see The Joker
Woo!
Here.
Woo!
Right, I know when the first trailer came out, because there have been so many incarnations of The Joker.
Yeah.
Everyone was kind of skeptical at the beginning, like, Joaquin Phoenix. I know he's a great actor, but what new can he bring to the character?
Yeah.
Since it's been done so many times. And then the trailer came out. And it shook everybody.
Yeah.
Even to the point that it's considered as an Oscar movie, as it's Oscar worthy.
Yeah.
How do you see this process of, I don't know, you can be vain, but Joaquin Phoenix, how has he transformed himself into the movie? What can you tell us about this process? You working on the set with Todd Phillips and also with Joaquin.
Yeah, I mean, you know, even initially when my agent sort of talked about there's a Joker movie, I was like, huh, you know, there's been so many made. But then I heard who was involved, and I was like, oh. And then I read the script, and I was like, get me in this movie. Like, I love the script so much. And, you know, I think, you know, there are multiple Jokers. We talk about, like, Keith Ledger,
Jack Nicholson.
You know, I feel like those two, for example, are in their own spaces equal, right? Like, I don't think they necessarily compete with each other as much as like complement each other as different iterations of one soul. And I mean, for me, I think Joaquin Phoenix is sort of another version of that, of like, I don't think it's trying to compete with what's already done, but just creating this other layer of this character that we can see and explore. The whole process, like Joaquin was just, you know, he was really in the character, and it was collaborative, and it was just like a great, it was a great time. I really, unfortunately, can't say like anything about the plot, otherwise I'll get sued maybe, I don't know. But, you know, it's like, I think it's going to be a really great story. I'm super excited to sort of share it with everybody.
And also Todd Phillips, he's known for comedies like the Hangover Trilogy. going down with the prestigious tones of the movie. It's kind of, in the beginning, kind of hard to accept it, but once you saw the trailer, it blew everybody out of their minds and accepted.
What's nice, I think, is with his experience with comedy is that he's also able to weave that into like a darker story, which, you know, that can sometimes be the mistake. If you do drama and you just go serious, oftentimes you lose an audience, I think, versus being able to sort of integrate that charisma of comedy. And, you know, he's a very introspective person. He's a very, very intelligent person. And, you know, I really trust this film in its hands.
So let's go ahead and start with the Q&A over here. First question.
Hello.
Oh, sorry. Your voice came from there.
Also, I just want to say very quickly, congratulations on your role of Domino and Double 2. You were fantastic in it.
Thank you.
Yeah, my first question is now with the whole Double 2 film out, are you planning to star in more comic book movies, or do you want to star in more other roles to experiment your performance?
At this point, I've been picking a lot of movies outside of the comic book world. I also think because I kind of want to also stay as pure to Domino, I guess, as I can, and not necessarily dilute it with other characters. You know, for me, sort of honoring her is like, this is my role in this universe. That being said, I'm a Joker. So I think I've really just been reading scripts and seeing what really speaks to me and trying not to be too prescriptive about like, this is something or a genre I'm definitely not doing and this is a genre I'm definitely doing, because different things resonate with me. You know, with the Joker, I remember reading the script and being so wonderfully just like, wow, this is a story I want to tell. And I didn't expect to be wanting to do another kind of movie in this sort of space of like superhero kind of. And so I, right now, I think I've been doing a lot more indies, as I just said, but you never know.
Alright, thanks for the question.
Thank you.
Do you like to be Domino in Deadpool 2?
I love being Domino in Deadpool 2. I love her comedy, you know, even though, you know, she's not as funny as Deadpool, she has, I think, her own, like, sarcasm humor, and I love her ease of how she goes with everything, and it's a fun thing to play with, and then also just I love working with everybody on that set, so thank you.
I think it's too young to see Deadpool.
Yeah, have you seen Deadpool?
As a huge fan of the Deadpool movies, how did it feel having to work with Ryan Reynolds on set?
That's the best. I mean, in a lot of movies, once the writer has like done the work, it gets handed off and then you like never really see them again. Which is not great, because often the inception of all these ideas and all and the stories and the characters can be lost if like the original mind that created these isn't there. And to also, like, if you're on set and you're doing a scene and, like, a line or something isn't working, they're right there to fix that problem. And you can also go to them and be like, well, what did you think about, you know, would she actually say something like this? Maybe this is my interpretation, but how do you interpret it? It's amazing to be able to have writers available there on set, and that they're also, like, accepted into the actual filmmaking and that their opinion is respected, which isn't always the case. So it's great. And then also I was like, damn, I better say this line good, otherwise I'm gonna ruin you know, what they wrote. So it's good. Fuel to the fire.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi. Okay. If Detective Pikachu gets a sequel, would you do it? Pikachu becomes Ryan Reynolds again. Would you do it?
Would I do it? Yeah, sure, if I could be Jigglypuff.
I was hoping Espeon.
Wait, I don't know that one. Which one is that?
That's the purple Eevee with the
Oh. Well, I like Jigglypuff because I'm like, I'm always kind of like. But I think Charmander. Growing up, Charmander was my favorite. I remember this one episode where he almost died. His own father was going out. I was like, I mean, that, I think, would be great comedic material there. Thank you. Hey, Batman.
How did you become an actor?
Ooh, that's always a big question. Well, I was acting, how old are you?
9.
You're 9? My first play, I was 7. And then I did some musicals, like 8, 9, 10. But that was just in school. That wasn't professional or anything. And it was kind of just like it was my hobby. It was the thing I did after school. And then in college, I studied French in college. But then after, I just felt I was doing theater for so long. I was like, man, I can't not give it a try. And so I did a bunch of scenes with these, like, directing students, and that way I met somebody who liked my work, and then they referred me to their agent, who's my agent now. So it's kind of this like meandering story, but if you are trying to be an actor, there are really great websites that you can go to, like Actors Access is one, or Casting Networks, where you can put up your headshot, you can put up your resume, it doesn't have to be big. It's a direct line to other directors and other people doing projects. So a lot of people who don't have representatives use that, and I did that too. So, and it's a great way to just meet young people who are making work. I don't know if that's like a boring answer to your question, but that's kind of, in short, how I started acting.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Hi.
Hi.
My heart is literally pounding right now.
So. Oh, okay. Mine too.
So my question is that in the set of Double Two, how was the work environment with Ryan Reynolds and Thanos himself, Josh Brolin?
Well, Thanos wasn't Thanos yet. I think he was actually shooting that. I think at the same time that we were shooting Deadpool, he would like fly back and forth. I think they were shooting Avengers in Atlanta, yeah. So he would like fly back and forth, if I remember correctly. But, I mean, like I said before, Josh is like a huge, like his favorite jokes are fart jokes. Like that's him on set. Like he's just a huge, like, he's really warm. He always has a crazy story. I think he always plays these scary characters, but he's always like, he's like laughing all the time and like getting everybody involved and always like joking and da da da. And then Ryan, because it was his baby, he was pretty busy because he also wrote it, he was producing it, he's starring in it. And if like I was having an issue with lines, he'd be like, let me go write something real quick. And so he was really kind of like involved, but then he's so like, I mean, his, you watch interviews with him, like his personality is Deadpool. he's Deadpool, but with like more empathy, I guess. And so, you know, he's funny. He's like funny to be around, and he's like great at adding levity to any conversation. And yeah, it was just like, it was a fun set. It was easy, fun. Julian, who plays Fire Fist, he's funny as hell. Everyone was great. Had a good time.
Thank you so much. You're so beautiful.
Oh, wow. Thank you. Thank you.
Hi. I'm going to ask the actual question.
How does it feel to be part of the Marvel universe, Marvel, Fox, / Disney, since Fox, and also being part of the DC universe since you're in Joker as well?
So I think DC had to ask Marvel permission if I could be a part of the universe. And you know, I really love kind of how far the Marvel Universe reaches and all the different stories that that you can follow with them, you know, whether it's like the Avengers or like the X-Men space. And I was so thrilled being cast in Deadpool and being a part of that. But growing up, I was actually a huge Batman fan growing up. I really enjoyed, I think I liked that superhero because he wasn't one, because he was a regular person, just intelligent and rich, I guess, but I liked like that element of it. So, and even sort of in the whole Batman story, right, like nobody really has powers, it's all just kind of an exploration of psychology. And so I was really excited to join that part of the story, and especially like this Joker, I feel, is this really kind of exploration of humanity and the mind. And so that's, as an actor, something exciting for me to do. So it's different, right? Like Domino is this strong action character, and then in this Joker thing, it's gonna be, I think, more of an emotional story. And so, for my experience, it's different. But I guess if I was like playing Superman in DC, maybe it'd be more similar. Blah, 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 rambling.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
What is your outtake of what goes on behind the camera, and what advice can you give somebody that wants to go out and become an actor?
I think, you know, there's a lot. There's so much preparation and so much time. I mean, so much of my time goes into reading scripts and looking at lines and memorizing, beyond memorizing, just like working through it. And like, I sometimes will journal as a character. And then also, I mean, I remember when, you know, I was working my day job still and doing auditions and stuff like that, I spent like hundreds of dollars on like makeup and clothes for auditions, because casting directors would be like, you need to wear more makeup, or you need to be dressing for the character. And like, I didn't work in an office, I didn't have office clothes, and I remember I'd be like running around trying to find an outfit that matches a character. Like, I didn't really wear makeup throughout as a teenager and in college. I just didn't really do that. And so I remember I was like learning kind of how to do my makeup. And I like learned a look that was like an audition look, and I would spend hours in Sephora trying on different things before I would like commit to buying. And it, you know, there's like a lot of money that, you know, you buy your headshots and you have to print them out, and there's a lot of effort and time. You do so much free work. But what's really beautiful about that, especially like the free work thing, is you're doing it with like the next generation of filmmakers, right? And like now there are people I used to work with 5, 6, 7 years ago who are huge in the industry now, right? And like, and you remember that, and then you're like, hey, like let me call you for this cool project I'm doing. And so there is something about like, you invest in your community and you support people you believe in, and you give your voice if you have a voice to give, because usually I find with like creative people, you get that favor back as well. So was that an answer to your question?
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Hey. Hi. I have a question for you.
Okay.
If you had the opportunity to choose a superhero, who would it be and why?
If I had the opportunity to choose a superhero to be? I mean, I really like, I really enjoy, I don't know if she counts as a superhero though, I think Harley Quinn is a lot of fun. You know, Margo is amazing at her, so I'm not gonna take her spot, but she's just like, she's crazy, and that's like kind of fun to do, you know? So I would love to kind of play in that space. That'd be fun.
Thank you.
Thank you.
In the Deadpool movies, you know that he always gives a shout out to the soundtrack, to cue the music. And what is your go-to personal songs in your preparation for each of your characters?
So if I have to be emotional in a scene, I have like a list of songs on my phone that are like my trigger songs to make me sad. One of which is the theme music to Inception. And so that's one. And I really like, I'll sit in a corner, I'll be like, all right guys, like, I'm not being mean, I need to go, like, I need to take a minute, and I need to, like, cry, and I'll watch, like, a sad video. Let me see, I have my phone right here, what do I have on this? I'll, like, watch a sad video, and it really works. Let me see, where is it? It's not in there. Sorry. Here we go. First one, Time, Inception. I listen to Eric Satie. He's this pianist. I listen to Porgy by Nina Simone. I listen to Solitude by Billie Holiday. I have on here Save Me by Nicki Minaj. So it's a range.
Like if I were to do an action movie, I go to the gym and listen to some Linkin Park and System of a Down.
Oh my god, Linkin Park. I know all the lyrics to In the End. That's my song.
Thank you so much. No,
thank you.
Any dubstep?
Hi.
Which one was your favorite scene of Deadpool 2?
My favorite scene of Deadpool 2? Okay. I love the X-Force scene when they're all like getting ready and jumping out the plane. Like that music, speaking of music, really like hypes me up. And I feel really cool when I'm like, ooh, I'm in the air. And also just like the Peter character, I hope he gets a spinoff. I love the team together, which is why I'm excited for the like hopeful X-Force movie coming out, because it was just like great having everybody on set, and just like I was like, yeah, we're like club. Like, it was just, I liked shooting that, and so watching that I find fun.
Luck is a power.
Yeah. You know, I think, space to, like, balance. And I think Josh Brolin does a really good job of being, like, an emotional, but then also knowing, like, this is what he has to do. And I just love that character. I think it's a really interesting character. So, yeah, I like watching him. Do you like Thanos, or no? No, you don't like Thanos. I get that, too.
Hi.
Hi.
I want to say, before I ask you this question, you did such a great job with Domino, really.
Thank you. Thank you.
I've been asking this question a lot to my friends, and I want to ask you, who do you think would win a fight? Batman or Iron Man?
Okay. Well, they're kind of like two of the same smart guys with gadgets.
And also richest guys ever.
I have to say, I think Iron Man. I think he'd win. I think he'd win in a battle of wits. I think he'd win in a battle of...
Humor.
I think he'd also, I don't know, his whole thing. I mean, he can, like, fly, and he can do fire, and, you know, Batman can, like, throw a little, like, ninja star. I think Iron Man would probably get the better of him.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
Thank you for coming to the Puerto Rico Comic Con.
Oh my God, I'm so glad. I'm here for work.
I also love your role as Domino.
Thank you.
My question for you is, which actor inspired to be an actress?
As a girl, I loved musicals.
Mm-hmm.
Specifically, I loved The Sound of Music and Singing Ooh. In the Rain. That was my fate. I watched that like on loop. And I would say probably, Julie Andrews was huge for me. I wanted to do Broadway. That was my thing. And then, you know, I like didn't take dance classes. So I'm doing movies. but I would say that, you know, the musicals and like Julie Andrews, Debbie Reynolds, those big actresses for me.
Thank you.
Also,
you should try more Fungos.
Oh, I'm gonna try. Somebody told me buy Fungo and try Fungo, and I was like, okay.
I'm a huge fan of your work, and also from the Batman movie, and also my boyfriend as well, like Steph Walla.
Oh, cool.
My question is, if you want to be in another movie, like Marvel, DC Comics, mm-hmm. What character you will be, though?
Well, I did say, like, Harley Quinn earlier was really interesting to me, and I was a huge fan of Batman. I mean, kind of like the Batman universe was something really that I as a kid, was like, I would watch the cartoon, and I liked him. So, Catwoman? I have a cat.
thank you very much
thank
for
you.
Your question, and welcome to Puerto Rico.
Thank you.
Hey. My question is, what were you studying before you became an actress?
So my high school that I went to was a public school, but you could do art there. So I did theater there. So it was like half the day you did theater, then half the day you did academics. There were a bunch of different schools like that. And then in college, which I was saying earlier, I did a French major in college, but I did, like I would take theater classes and I kept doing plays. And that's like the extent of my studying, kind of, for acting. I think, you know, I took some classes here and there. After school, I would take classes. And that was it. I mean, really, I think I did a lot of my learning by being on sets, too. Because I did theater growing up, and being on a movie set, still acting, but it is different. And so, kind of had to learn a lot on the job. you know, there's like the famous thing, like people in the theater always have really active eyebrows, and you like see that on screen and you're like, then calm down. So it's like kind of like a lot of little details like that. So I hope that answered your question.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
I really love your work in Atlanta.
Thank
and,
you.
And I mean, that show is one of my favorite performances of you. Is there any update to season 3?
Oh. You tell me. Well, no, we're kidding. Hopefully we shoot, I think, in the fall, I think is the projected time. But the, honestly, because of the show, everybody's schedules have been really, really busy. And so they're trying, I think, to find a window where we can all fit. And it's kind of beautiful because it's like, thanks to the show, everybody's busy, but then it also, it makes it hard to have everybody line up. But I think the last I heard was hopefully we start shooting around September. So,
that's good.
Yeah.
I can imagine everybody's busy. I mean, Donald Glover's voice in Simba.
Yeah.
I forgot his name, but he plays Paperboy. He's going to be in Child's Play.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
everybody's busy. So yeah.
Yeah.
My favorite episode of yours is the Oktoberfest episode.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Thank
you.
I loved shooting that episode. We had a good time. They cut out all this stuff that was like really fun. I was like, whatever. You know, whatever. It's good. I think it was a great episode.
Right.
Thank you.
Have a good day.
You too. Thank you.
Hello.
Hi.
Okay, I am curious to know which was your reaction when you found out that you were going to play Antonio? Like,
I think I cried. Yeah, I cried. I remember that morning I woke up to a text from Ryan Reynolds and I was like, interesting. And he was just like, hey, how are you doing? And I was like, I'm good. he was like, is it okay if me and Dave, the director, he was like, we might give you a call a little bit later. This was maybe like 2 weeks after I read with them and did like a formal audition with them. And I was like, yeah, I was like, call me. And I remember I was walking to the subway and it had to be quick because I probably had some appointment, I don't know. And they're like, so I just want to tell you, like, you got the role. And I was like, and I cried. I started crying, you know, and I was like, thank you for trusting me. And they were like, don't tell your agents we said anything. We want them to be able to tell you. And I was like, okay. Obviously, I didn't not tell them. And so, yeah, it's interesting. It's one of those moments in your life where you're like, my entire life is about to change. And I felt that. So.
And that you worked so long for it.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. Yeah.
Well, have a great time in Puerto Rico.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi.
And welcome to Puerto Rico again.
Thank you.
My question is, the Disney Fox is already almost completed. Which way or which route do you prefer the Domino character should go? The more kid-friendly Disney version or the already established edgy R-rated Fox version?
I love saying, well, there are all these children here. I think edgy is the way to go. Yeah, for sure. 100%. I mean, Avengers being PG-13 is great, but I love that Deadpool has an R on it, and I would love for Domino to follow in his footsteps. Please, Disney. But they have their other stuff going on. They have Lion King coming out. They have Aladdin coming out. They'll be good. Domino can be great at R.
Thank you. Have a nice stay here in Puerto Rico.
Thank you.
We're almost done here. I would like to end up in a high note.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, I want you, if there was an advice or something that somebody told you that inspired you to keep on going. I know that being an actress is not an easy job. It's not like you show up at LA or New York and here I am.
Yeah.
Give me the job.
Yeah.
So it's a hard work. What advice you received that motivated you to go to your and keep doing it for your dream, that dream, that passion?
I think really just staying authentic to yourself, right? Like, what do you need to do, even if it's like hard to get there or hard in between? Like, even now, like, I'm in this place, but it's still, sometimes it's hard work. But I feel so driven to tell certain stories and to connect with people and to honor, for me, the girl that loved being on stage, and I just want to like do right by her. And I feel like she's sort of my most authentic self in a way, and you know, I wanna like respect all the expectations she had and put in the work for her. So
thank you,
thank you, everybody, for coming.